a landscape so alien, NASA used it to train for the moon missions. But this amazing crater wasn't caused by anything from outer space. It was made by a massive explosion that came from the depths of the Earth itself.
I gotta tell you, one of the best parts of my job is getting to see and do things that I wouldn't have had the chance to experience otherwise, really. And today it's the world-famous Lunar Crater. And that's why I have with me Paul Amar from the BLM. Nice to see you, buddy.
John, good to see you. Thanks for coming out.
Now let's orient everybody. Where are we exactly?
So we're 75 miles east of Tonopah, Nevada. We're on the south end of the Pancake Range, and we're on the Lunar Crater Backcountry Byway.
The Lunar Crater Backcountry Byway is a 24-mile-long unpaved loop accessible from Route 6. Don't count on cell phone service here. You're definitely off the beaten path.
What exactly do you do for the BLM?
I'm an outdoor rec planner, so that includes, you know, management of sites like this, campgrounds, permits for things like Vegas to Reno, races, that sort of thing.
And what's one of the best parts of your job?
Definitely getting out here on the ground. Lunar Crater, getting to see the sights, the opportunity to go out and really experience what a lot of people don't always get to see.
Why are we standing here talking? Let's go check it out.
Let's hit it.
The Lunar Crater was added to the National Natural Landmark Register in 1973. And looking around at its magnificent, otherworldly beauty, it's easy to see why.
Paul, I gotta tell you, now that I'm finally here, and I've always wanted to come here, this does not disappoint. This is just awesome, but it's massive. How big is this?
It's huge, right? It's 3,000 feet wide. It's around 450 feet deep. It's big. There's over 2,000 acres that encapsulate this landmark.
How did it get here? It was not a meteor?
It's not a meteor, right? So we call it the Lunar Crater, but what it's referred to as geologically is a maar. So what traditionally will happen is, you know, magma, lava, as it rises into a dome typical structure, and then the top of the volcano explodes, as we're used to seeing. What happens with a maar is it starts to form, it runs into a sheet of water and just explodes, and then immediately collapses onto itself, and it gives you that perfect bowl shape.
Maars often fill up with water to create a lake. This being Nevada, the Lunar Crater is almost always quite dry, but it will hold water after a rain.
Are there more like this in the area?
There are. So within the Pancake Range, which we're situated in, there's also Easy Chair Crater, there's lava fields nearby. A lot was going on when the Earth was rumbling and moving.
And about when are we talking?
Estimates range, but we kind of narrowed it down to around 15,000 years ago.
You know, that doesn't sound like a lot.
You
know, geologically, that's just a blink of an eye.
It's kind of scary when you think about it, but yeah, not that long ago.
Scientists believe that this area may still be volcanically active. But since the next eruption could be hundreds of thousands of years away, it's extremely unlikely that it's going to blow up during our visit.
So it's called the Lunar Crater. But what does this have to do exactly with the moon?
So in training for their lunar landings in the 60s and 70s, the astronauts came here. They tested their vehicles here. They tested their suits here. They collected core samples. They worked on their communication skill set. In fact, one of the great stories of that training is, you know, as in a big caravan of being out here and training together, one of the few that were in a vehicle got left behind. They broke down, and one of the astronauts had to hoof it all the way through the crater to the other side to flag down his team. They didn't have cell phones back then. There was no way, and they were going to spend the night out here, and it's pretty cold at night. So it was quite a time to
That's
be here.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
And when you stand up here and you look down, you can almost see them down there training. It's kind of eerie, isn't it?
It's hard not to imagine this as a crater, as a moon landscape when you look at it. I mean, it's got that moon landscape. It's pocked, it's, you know, cobbled stones. You look out there and it looks like the layer of the moon.
And this is, it's remote, but it's accessible.
It is. So we're 75 miles east of Tonopah. We're on the backcountry byway. So we're out here, but you can get to it pretty easily. And the greatest thing is there's no lines. You can come right here, lay your hands on the natural resources.
Incredible. And I love that. Can I camp here?
You can camp here. We, you know, this is BLM land. These are your lands. We want people to come out here. You know, don't create new roads, follow leave no trace ethics, take pictures, only leave footprints. And yeah, if you want to hike out and set your tent up off the crater, absolutely.
Luckily, you don't have to leave the planet to enjoy the out of this world view.
I know the awe that I feel when I see this. How do you feel when you come here and you look?
You know, for me, it's that sense of solitude. The vastness of Nevada really takes you into the area. In fact, a gentleman in my position, a rec planner, this was his favorite spot on the entire district. We have 10.6 million acres, and this was the area he came to reflect. And his family actually put in a bench to memorialize him there. And that says a lot. For that 10.6 million acres, this is the one spot that he wanted to be remembered and his family remembered him at.
I can see why, because it's timeless. It's so still, but you could look at it forever.
Every time I come here, you find something different. There's something different to look at. You do have that opportunity to unplug and think in a different way.
450 feet to the bottom. Have you ever been down there?
I haven't. I've asked myself every time I've come here, will I have time? Will today be the day? What do you think?
Let's get to the bottom of it.
Let's go.
All right.
The trail down is pretty rugged, so wear hiking boots. Now, once in the crater, it's easy to imagine you're walking on the surface of the moon, only without the bulky spacesuits.
Oh, that's a pretty good hike.
I'm seeing the end.
We're there. Ooh. We're almost there.
Oh, I gotta tell you, when we were going down, I think it was kind of like that. Coming up.
Straight up. John, thank you.
Thank you, brother.
Lunar Crater is one of Nevada's 6 national natural landmarks.
We were looking for little pieces of NASA equipment, but we came up empty on that deal.
Came up short, but we got to see the bottom.
Man, just knock that one off the list. We did it. Thanks again, buddy.
Thank you. Let's get out of here.
Let's get some water.
All right.
The Lunar Crater is 288 miles from Reno, but the moon is around 238,000 miles away. It's a much easier trip, and it's well worth it.
Well, this is it. This is the bench that was placed here in honor of John Joseph, who loved to come here and just contemplate the silence and the peace and the awe and the history of Lunar Crater. And I get it. It's been here over 15,000 years, and somehow it seems like there's still just not enough time to take it all in.